Hey, I'm not surprised, mother.
What's up guys, Sal here. So the debate of Exynos versus Snapdragon has been raging for generations of Galaxy models, but it came to a head in early 2020 when benchmarks of the Exynos 990 versus Snapdragon 865 appeared. I won't go into detail, but the bottom line is that the Exynos 990 was not only slower, particularly for gaming, but also turned out to be less energy efficient in CPU demanding scenarios. Since the Galaxy Note 20 and Note 20 Ultra uses an upgraded Snapdragon 865 Plus processor while keeping the same old Exynos 990, I don't think the question here is whether or not the Exynos is gonna win, but how much of a difference is there gonna be between the two. Thankfully, we have just the right person to reveal to us what Samsung doesn't want us to know. Gary from SpeedTestG did a speed test between the Exynos and Snapdragon variants of the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra. I'll link the full video in the description box below, do check that out. In short, the Exynos 990 model has a head start for a few seconds, after which it falls behind and never recovers. In the end, the Snapdragon variant of the Note 20 Ultra finished the test in 1 minute 32 seconds, whereas the Exynos was 18 seconds slower than its counterpart. 18 seconds is a big difference when you consider that the whole test lasted less than 2 minutes. Exynos is a big disappointment. They've been letting us down ever since the Galaxy S9, and this year is no different. But here's something to cheer about for Exynos users. The Exynos 990 on the Note 20 Ultra actually managed to perform better than the one on the S20 series. The S20 Plus finished the same test in 2 minutes, while the Note 20 Ultra did it in 1 minute 50 seconds. It shows that Samsung has better optimized the chipset this time. There was a rumor that Samsung has installed a better cooling system on the Note 20 Ultra. The main problem with Exynos chipset is that it gets hot pretty quickly, and to cool it down, the phone throttles and reduces the performance. A better cooling system would counteract this a little bit, and it looks like that's exactly what Samsung did on the Note 20 Ultra. I'll check that out on my Note 20 Ultra once it arrives and compare it with the S20 Ultra and we'll let you know. It should be worth mentioning that this is a synthetic benchmark test and it might not reflect the real world performance with complete accuracy, but it should give you a basic idea of the capabilities of these two chipsets. The Galaxy S20 series is getting the latest version of One UI software, the One UI 2.5, which debuted with the Galaxy Note 20. Along with it is bringing some Note 20 features such as wireless text, a new updated notes app that lets you sync audio recording with written notes. There are also a couple of new camera features, like the fact that Pro Video Mode can now manually switch between the phone's different mics and supports 8K video recording at 24 frames per second. Also, the ability to share Wi-Fi credential with a QR code. Right now, the update is rolling out to many countries in Europe, so you should keep an eye on your notification if you have the S20. Also, the S10 and Note 10 owners will get these features gradually. Of course, with that being said, for all the latest updates on smartphone tech, please be sure to subscribe. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.